الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وآله وصحبه ومن والاه. Today is the 8th of Sha'ban. I'd like to have the opportunity to discuss main understandings of the Siyam, of the month of Ramadan. I think that we are in need of this information. So today, I'd like to talk about Ramadan, and we are expecting Ramadan according to calculations on the 28th of June. And we are expecting the first of Shawwal to be the 28th of July according to calculations. So Allah says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام. When he says يا أيها الذين آمنوا, it means all Muslims, those who assimilated the pillars of al-Iman, and they are already practicing the pillars of al-Iman and al-Deen. And you know that the Quran counted 5 pillars of al-Iman and counted 5 pillars of al-Islam. So those who assimilated all these pillars are يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ. Look, كُتِبَ, it means to be in writing. There are certain laws without being in writing, and some other laws, some other specific laws are put in the Quran with in writing. We have as-siyam. We have combating al-qital. Kutiba alaykum al-qital. Kutiba alaykum as-siyam. Kutiba alaykum idha ahadara ahadakum mawtu in taraka khayran al-wasiyyatu. Al-wasiyya, the bequest or the will, should be understood that it's very important, and Allah put it as an obligation, as a matter being in writing. So again, as-siyam, al-qital, al-wasiyya, those who are predestined to be killed in the battlefield, كَتَبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقَتْلِ. So being killed, it is something decided as a matter of qadr in writing. So I want to explain to you, why is it in writing? It means there are 6 areas in the Quran, as I remember, which are accompanied with being in writing. In writing, in order to understand the articulation and the significance of that hukum. Even you see in the Quran, you can hardly find as-siyam mentioned. It is mentioned in very few ayat. But look about as-salah, how often it is mentioned in the Quran. As-zakah, how often it is mentioned in the Quran. You see, as-siyam is so important, and it is distinguished by being of articulation, of paying attention. And you see, look at yourself when you are waiting for the iftar, how you are counting seconds but not minutes, waiting for the iftar, okay? And the same thing when you want to stop practicing iftar, you wait for the fajr again, you are very punctual, and you are checking the time of as-suhoor or al-imsak. So then These are of the meanings that are understood in the word kutiba alaykum as-siyam. Number two, the name of Ramadan. We say Ramadan. The name of Ramadan is known because of dehydration, shortage of water. Ramadan is the peak of heat, is the heat of the weather. When the temperature, now you go to some countries, when you go Middle East, in Arabia, in Gulf countries, in Iraq, you see that the temperature is 45 centigrade, which is 120 or more or less, it's very hot. And you see the people would suffer dehydration more than suffering shortage of food. The fasting person is very worried about being thirsty and being too thirsty and being dehydrated. This is why we read in fiqh, in case somebody is losing hydration in his body and he is fully dehydrated and he falls down because of dehydration, then he will breakfast and drink water, because he under that obligation of losing water or of losing hydration in his body. So the fiqh discusses that. So there are people maybe who are having a job that caused them dehydration. Anyhow, the most important thing to know is the name of Ramadan is taken from dehydration or from the heat of the season. Because of the heat, it is taken from Ramadan. Ramadan, it means the heat. And Ramadan is the wide area of the effect of being under heat or being dehydrated. Now, كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم. My point number three, that الصيام is not an extra عباده which is outside the entity of man. Like now, who can tell me I can leave my heart at home and come without my heart? Is there anybody without his heart here? No. Is anyone without any of his kidneys? No. Anyone without a lung? No. The same way, when Allah created me, He, as the way He created the heart, the way He created the blood vessels, the way He created my legs, Allah created salah, siyam, zakah, and other obligations of deen, not because He is in need of any, not because I'm doing Allah a favor that when I make salah, no. You should make it for yourself, because if you don't make it, you will get sick. I say to you, now you see, look at yourself. How you trust the doctor? When you go to a doctor, I know that in any family there is somebody who goes to, for example, physical therapy. The other one goes to a psychologist or psychiatrist. The other one goes to internalist. The other one goes to cardiologist. So we are involved in referring to doctors. But unfortunately, we don't have a doctor for salah or a doctor for siyam or a doctor for zakah, which is our mistake. Our mistake. I always, when people come to me for marriage, I explain this to them. I say, Do you know why we study chemistry, physics, geology, biology, zoology, etc.? Anything with G? You know why? To discover the laws of universe. And one of the laws of universe is the Salah. Exactly like saying HSO4 is such and such of a chemical formula. When you talk about something in physics, you talk about acceleration or gravity or magnet or something like that. When you go to geology, you again come to another topic. The same thing I say, a human being is born but missing certain things, will be completed by his family or by him. You know, when your wife goes to hospital in order to deliver a baby, what does she take with her? She doesn't take milk. She takes the clothes of a baby, because the baby will be born nude, without any clothes. He's in need of the clothes, so the mother brought the clothes, okay? But other things, Allah is the provider directly. When the baby is in need of the milk, the mother is ready to breastfeed the baby. So the milk is there. The only thing she buys, the clothes for the baby. And again, Allah created you, but you should make the salah. The way you eat, would you stop eating? They say there were very lazy people, and they were starving, not eating. And somebody was very compassionate, and he took them in a car to feed them. They arrived at the place. He said to them, get out. What for? To eat. No, we cannot move to eat. You should bring us the food. You see how lazy they are? The same thing when I say to somebody, why don't you make salah? Sheikh, make me dua. Allah could make me dua. Allah gives me hidayah. Allah hasn't guided me yet. You see, sick answers. So I'd like to focus on this point, that any obligation of deen is for the maintenance of your entity, of your body, physically, psychologically, mentally, emotionally. You cannot be healthy without salah, siyam, zakah, hajj, etc. Those are integrations of your entity. Not you are having Islam as a garment. When I arrive home, I change my clothes and I'm going to take off Islam and hang it. So when I want to practice Islam, I again wear. There is no such an image at all. Again, I say as-siyam, as-salah, without which, Allah says, you will have ma'ishatan danka, very tough life. And don't ever believe anyone who says to you, there are non-Muslims who are happy in their lives. It is a lie, a big lie. A big lie to believe that there is any person who could be stable and have good peace of mind without practicing Islam. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُشْرِكِينَ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةِ. Allah says, وَيْلٌ for the mushriks who don't pay zakah. I was wondering years ago, how come Allah addresses the mushriks saying, you will have Jahannam because you don't give zakah, or you will have a wail because you don't give zakah? Then I learned that because az-zakah is something integral to their entity, similar to the blood, similar to the skin, similar to the bones. No one can do without any of what I counted. So no human being could ever do without salah, without zakah. This is why the birds, the insects, any animal practice salah, practice sujood. You don't read in the Quran about the flocks of birds flying above our head, flying, and Allah says, each bird has already known its own salah and its own tasbih. كُلٌّ قَدْ عَلِمَ صَلَاتَهُ وَتَسْبِيحَهُ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِمَا يَفْعَلُونَ. You read in the Quran, to Allah, everything makes sujood. وَلِلَّهِ يَسْجُدُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Everything makes sujood. Then we understand that as it is a natural way of maintenance for our entity, for our body, physically, mentally, psychologically, emotionally, then all the creatures, this wood has the same commitment. This makes salah, makes sujood. You see, Allah says, وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ. There is nothing, no creature would ever do without making tasbih. But you don't comprehend, or you don't understand, or you don't feel their tasbih. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ. Is there anybody who could say to me that this wood is not making tasbih, or this floor is not making tasbih, or the carpet you are sitting on doesn't make tasbih? No, you cannot say that. This is the open verses of the Quran. So then we should understand that Ramadan is prescribed because man cannot live or exist without salah and siyam and other obligations of deen. They are biological, they are physical, they are whatsoever you can count. So Allah says, كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. As-siyam is prescribed upon you as well as it is done for preceding generations, preceding people. The first moment Allah created man, He created him to practice those integrations which are inevitable, and each creature practiced them. As-salah, as-siyam, as-zakah, and other practices of obligations of deen. So I want today to just give you the message that as-siyam is nothing additional to what you are. It is integral to what you are. You look at yourself, sometimes you see shortage of a certain vitamin. Oh, I have shortage of iron in my blood. And you run to the store to have iron, vitamin. And I know everyone is concerned about vitamins, about dietary, about. I say to everyone, as-siyam and as-salah should be of everyone's dietary. And the one who doesn't practice these steps of practice would never be healthy and will be always depressed and distressed. May Allah bless you, and inshallah, don't forget your sadaqah to cleanse yourselves and to make it in a good feeling with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you remember that you put any sadaqah in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aqim as-salah.